Hi, my name's Ed Brickler. I'm the Education Director for ChartPack. And today we're going to be doing a demonstration using our Kohinoor smooth Bristol. We already have artwork printed, which we're going to work on. Pages come out of the book. We will work directly on them that way. We will also be using the Spectra AD marker. One of the things about the marker is that it has a nib that's cut on an angle. It also has a round brush nib. This nib gives us three different lines. A thick line, if we turn it on its side, we get a smaller line, and if I put it up high, I get a really narrow line. One of the things about the brush pen, I'm a painter, so I like using the brush because I can vary the line width from very thin to thick. Okay, so we'll be using that when we color in our product. These markers are available in 96 different colors, and that includes one colorless blender. They are also refillable, so you can insert this into the pen, refill it as needed. Another product we're going to be using is the Higgins brush marker. It is filled with our Higgins Black Magic ink. It is a fine point, so I can get a very thin line, press down and get a very thick line. These are refillable. To get this activated, once the ink gets low, there's a hole in the end of the cap. You put the nib in, press down once, and it reactivates it so I can get a nice dark line. Like I say, I'm a painter, so I like using the brush point of this. And on the Bristol has somewhat of an absorbency. So when I mark my lines down, I get a good absorbency of the marker into the paper. One of the things to remember is that when you put marker down, is that it's dark and it lightens up as it dries. If you're doing a project like this and it's on inkjet with an inkjet printer, you do have to put a fixative over the inkjet ink. If not, the marker will bleed the lines. And this was done on a printing press, so it's a very durable line. And what we chose here as our image was basically the Las Vegas iconic sign. And then we changed it, put the in and out in there because that's what our pages are called, where you pull them out, put them back in. And I'll demonstrate that, putting the page back in when we're all finished. Next color I'm going to choose will be for the standard sign. And here I'm going to use the flat marker because I have a flat area, so I could save a lot of time. Even the shadowed area I'm going to go and fill in because I can go over the top of this marker. This is an alcohol-based marker, so it's basically rubbing alcohol. Not a strong smell, so it's not harmful. They do have an AP seal on them, which means it's non-toxic, so it's safe to use. Now I'm going to choose the next blue, which is one level up. And there, what I'm going to do is fill in the shadow. And then I'm going to choose this other blue just to finish up some of these letters in here. I'm going to take my darker yellow to add some accent. Oops. Let's use the brush tip. So you can see you could work with one color over the other. The best way, the system of working is light to dark. So I started with a light yellow, and then I could go over to dark yellow. It comes really obvious if you have a dark color and you put a light color over it, it's not gonna work. But I could use a blue with the yellow and create green. So you layer, just like you would work with watercolors, very similar. Okay, for the last part, we're gonna use our brush marker. I'll make sure it works. And I chose this to put in here because you have to maintain control when you're doing the lettering. And so you want to touch it very lightly. you maintain a lot of control with that little bitty point that's there. And you could go on and accent this with colored pencil. You could add other mediums into it and whatever you like. And of course, once we're finished, we take our book. We can put the artwork back in. This is the only spiral-bound Bristol book you're going to find on the market. And most of them are tape-bound, so we have spiral. Also, it's the only 5.5 by 8.5 book that you'll find used. But now your book, your sketchbook becomes a storage facility, so I can work on the next page, put it in. If I'm doing some work in creating storyboards or color mixing guides, I could actually put everything in order at when I'm finished, or my notes, okay? You could do that. For more information on Chartback products, please visit our websites. We own 14 legacy companies, so we have a lot of different products to choose from. But if you go to our website, you can find all those. They're all listed on that website.